Yo, what's up? This is your boy Lisiwe Motupi, and I appreciate you coming back to my YouTube channel to be watching the content that I drop each and every day. Now, on today's video, we're going to be talking about what Forex can do for you. But before we dive in a bit onto that, it's going to be a short video. Yesterday, I've done something a bit longer than anticipated, but today's going to be a short video. But before we dive into that, I want to just take a quick look at the trade that I just shared with my premium members now, and let us see how it is going. Okay, you can simply see that this is Euro USD current market time. So we just shared this trade like an hour ago with the premium team. You can simply see here. Okay, let me just open this up. You can simply see before it broke out and it's moving slightly well. So I believe that it's gonna as soon as this candle closes, we can put it on break even and then target this three. It's a risk reward of 1:3. Never take a trade less than 1:3 on the risk reward. Stop loss should never exceed 30 pips. You can simply see here, it's exactly 30 pips. Should never exceed 30 pips. That's the way to go. So yeah, I just shared this now and I believe that the members are eating. But let us get back to the topic of today's video. So we are going to be speaking about what Forex can do for you, and I've got you 3 points that can help you out. So the first one that I'd like to say is that before I just started out trading Forex, yes, I always wanted to just make a lot of profits from the Forex market, but also I wanted to just build something on the side, just so whether I place a trade or I don't place a trade, I still get to make money. So one thing, the number one factor that I'll give to you guys is that Forex allows you to open multiple businesses, meaning that if you are interested in, I don't know, fashion, and you're trading Forex, you make profits, you can start up a fashion company, then you fund it yourself. You don't need to have investors. I don't have investors on whatever project that I work in. It's just all the money that I get from the market, and then I just invested in something different. So currently I've got like 5 streams of income, including Forex, and I'm started with Forex. Like, it's the only stream of income I had first, and then obviously with the profits you get to build and build and build and build, and then it leads to something epic. And then in the next weeks, obviously it's going to be a few more income streams. It's something that I'm working on, but I'll just mention in the area, I'm in the later stages. So it allows you to have multiple businesses. Whatever business that you want, you can just keep fund on it, and then keep on the profits that you make, keep on funding it to generate cash flow. And once your business is good, you can go to the next one, or you can just scale it and build a much more bigger business. So that's the number one thing. That's the advantage of trading Forex, okay? So another thing that I like about it is that you can work from anywhere and anytime. That's one thing that I like more. Not anywhere part, but the anytime part. Because literally today I went to go skate in the morning. So ever since the morning I went to go skate, came back maybe 2 hours ago, and I got back in my office here. And then what I done is that I took a quick shower, and then I sat, then I just analyzed a few pays. Took me like 20-30 minutes, and I spotted like 2 or 3 opportunities, and then I put trades, shared with the premium members, and now I'm gonna go out to go check out my friend. So yeah, that's something that I like. You know, you can get to the times that you work. You don't need to trade like in the morning or in the evening or at night. It's just once you get it, it's just you making up the own time. And once you become better at it, you will learn that you're gonna start trading few, like, let's say not much more than before, because like at first I was trading a lot, I was always on the charts and stuff. But now I like being on the charts, but I'm not trading that much. Like I am actually analyzing, I'm learning, and whenever I'm placing trades, it can take me like literally an hour or two maximum to just if let's say I just want to place trades, I'll just get on the charts, analyze, come up with possible scenarios, all those things, get my entries, and then I'm done. Then I don't have to look at, currently I just place trades, I don't have to look at the markets anymore. I'll look maybe later tonight, you know, after a few hours, to just see how the progress is going. But after this candle closes too, I'm gonna put it to break even, and yeah, I believe that it's gonna go well. But that's the second one. You can trade anywhere and anytime. Obviously with your laptop, you can just press around. Like, if you're chilling in the restaurant or you're at the beach or you're everywhere, you can just get to experience that. And the third one, the third and last one is that, you can make large amounts of money. Okay, yeah, this one here is that obviously you can make large amounts of money. I'm sure, like, even if you see wherever, like, the people that you follow, maybe if let's say it's on Instagram or it's just on YouTube or all those things, you see people making ridiculous amounts of money, and it's very much possible. At the same time, it shouldn't give you that mentality that you are also gonna get those results as soon as you get into the markets, but it should give you that mentality of it's possible for you to make those. Like, for instance, when I noticed that people were making a lot of money from Forex, I didn't think that I'm also gonna make the same exact profits as they did, like a lot of money instantly, all those, because I don't understand their story, where they come from, you know. Maybe they had someone to fund the account to a bigger account just so they can trade much better, I don't know. Or maybe even if, let's say, they blow their accounts, they can always get more money. But for me, it has always been the thing where I have to protect the money that I have, because after the money's gone, I have to go start from zero and hustle my way up to funding my account again. So, you know, like those kind of, growing up in that way also showed me that we're not all the same. So instead, but the reason that we're making so much money, it also gave me some positivity and something to choose that it's very much possible, you know, for me to also be able to make like tens of thousands of dollars with just trading on the markets, you know, so that it's very much possible. And just your accounts, once your accounts get bigger, when you just keep on scaling it and it gets much more big and bigger, you understand that, okay, no, what used to excite you doesn't excite you so much. I used to get excited to making like hundreds of dollars, like yeah, $100 and stuff, but now it doesn't excite me so much, because like as soon as I just place a trade, within the next hour it should be on $100 and stuff. And you know, you just understand that there comes a time whereby making large amounts of money doesn't really excite you that much, because it's not more on making those money. Like when you become a bit more profitable, you understand that you're not too focused on making money, but you're too focused on being protecting your capital, being a little bit more like reducing the risk to have as much rewards as possible. And once you get this mindset, once you get the mindset of reducing risk and having a lot of rewards as possible, you can implement that strategy in every type of business. You know, as long as the risk is small, as long as you're risking a dollar, you're making three or more, then you can use that in each and every type of business, and you can just keep on scaling it and growing into a larger amount of capital. So yeah, that's the third one. There you can make large amounts of money, which is very possible. So just don't give up on your journey. If you're losing, if you're blowing accounts or doing all these types of things, just keep on learning. Focus on the learning side of it, and then you'll just notice that once you are learning, things will just start to become better, you know. It doesn't mean that overnight you're going to make a lot, but you'll just see yourself losing less, and you'll just see yourself locking a few profits. You'll see yourself being able to make a number of profits. Like, things will change slowly, and it'll become a habit that you are used to, and it gets boring because you're used to it, you know. So yeah, that's the third one. But yeah, that's the video that I've got for today. I'll just see you guys again tomorrow with another dropout of the video. So yeah, please do subscribe, please do like this video here, and tell me what do you guys think of the things that I just said to you. Thanks.